klaar voor?
Ja. Maar ik wil graag dat het interview in het Engels wordt gedaan.
En waarom?
Om een internationaal publiek te bereiken.
Oké. Okay. Are you ready?
Yes. I am. But are you?
So, what happened that morning, the 1st of February?
I was hiking that morning. There was some kind of taste, like a taste of metal in the air. I ignored it and kept walking for some time. Then I saw this campsite of some hikers, maybe. It was weird at first. The hiker's tent was flat laying on the ground. There were clothes and some stuff. But I found nobody. No wind. No birds. Nothing. Just silence. I reported it to the police.
What happened then?
They closed the whole case in a week. The official report stated it was a homeless man who lived there and then he went missing. But that's not possible.
Why is that not possible?
Because I saw them there. I saw those hikers.
But you said you only saw some clothes and stuff.
True. But I found a camera.
And the police, they didn't take it?
I took the card out of the camera.
Why didn't you give it to the police?
I don't trust them.
You know it's unlawful to hide evidence, right?
There will be no laws left when this interview ends.
What do you mean by that? No laws?
You will get that part later.
So, what did you see on the camera?
I saw some normal hiking videos, some photos. Except? The very last video on that camera. That was a little bizarre.
Why was it bizarre?
Do you want to see it?
Sure.
What do you think?
An explosion?
That video, that made me more curious about that place. So, I did my investigation.
What did you investigate?
I knew something was not right. I was looking for an explanation. After all, I am an astrophysicist. Because of the taste of metal in the air, I first started with some radiation tests. And I found that when I went closer to that tent, the radiation started increasing above normal levels.
A nuclear cover-up?
No. With that much amount of radiation, if there was a cover-up, then the whole city would have been evacuated by now. I did more investigation of that specific area. I checked the magnetic field of that area. My compass was not working. There was no mobile signal. It was like a complete dead zone. I went there every day, looking for an explanation. But that day, I found something.
What did you find?
My apple fell on the ground. But it didn't fall straight on the ground. It fell in a curve. First, I thought the cause of diversion was the wind. But then I realized it was...
What was it?
Gravity.
Gravity?
I threw my apple again and again. But it fell right at the same point. Like there was a magnet under the ground, which was attracting my apple. The next day, I took a bunch of things from my house. Small things. I started throwing with them. And guess what? There was not one, not 10, but hundreds of points on the ground. Hundreds of magnets attracting things. I started drawing those dots. I kept doing it every day till my book was full of patterns of dots. They were not any ordinary dots. They were not made by something ordinary.
Was it a natural phenomenon?
Whoever made those dots was not natural. And they made those dots for a reason.
What reason?
To communicate in a sort of universal language.
A universal language? What is that? Those dots?
No. Mathematics.
Math. So you're saying dot plus dot is two dots? And that is supposed to mean something in their language?
Look, one plus one is two. That's universal for everyone. They may break some laws of the Newtonian physics, but they can't change how math works. I think they shared information.
What kind of information did they share with you?
A lot. I better keep it simple. For you and for the viewers. I decoded their dots into mathematical equations. At first I thought they were just random. But as soon as I brought the aspects of gravity and time in it, I know it's more than that. Let me show you something.
Okay, what is this?
It's an atomic clock. It's based on their equations.
And how is this different than any other clock?
Well, An atomic clock measures time very precisely.
Okay, so you're gonna measure time with it?
No, I'm going to slow it down.
So it's like a time machine then?
Not really. In a time machine, you can go in the future and in the past. But with this one, you can slow the time down.
Okay. Prove it to me.
May I have your watch? What time is it?
It's 4 o'clock. So, this machine, how is it going to slow it down?
You will see.
And haven't we already invented an atomic clock?
Yes, humans already have an atomic clock, but my atomic clock does something more than only measuring time.
What does all this has to do with the disappearance of the hikers?
That's a good question. That explosion near the hikers' tent was an antimatter explosion out of this world.
Those hikers, they disappeared due to an explosion?
Yes, an antimatter explosion.
And what is antimatter?
You see that dust over there? This is from the hiker's tent. There was no radiation, but antimatter was scattered in that area all around. This is way beyond our knowledge.
Then how are you using it?
I'm just doing it based on their equations. Okay, let's see. The time is now 4:05. Let's check yours.
For 4:01? Just 1 minute has passed. How is that even possible?
Extraordinary claims require extraordinary evidence.
So, these beings, they just shared this knowledge with you. But why?
These beings are not like us.
What are these beings then?
They are fifth-dimensional beings. But let's keep it simple. Look. This line is one-dimensional. This rectangle is two-dimensional. This cube is three-dimensional.
Then what are the fourth and the fifth?
Time and gravity. These beings can control time and gravity. Just like I did with your watch, by slowing it down.
And where do they come from?
They have traveled across an ocean of stars to reach us.
And what are they here for?
They are here for
our Earth?
No, they are here for our sun.
So they're here to take our sun. Is that even possible?
Yes, of course it's possible.
Well, maybe you should write a book on this, or make a movie out of it.
I knew you wouldn't believe me.
You know what I believe? I believe this interview is over.
Look, look, look. You have to hear me out. Just let me explain. It's already happening right now.
What is already happening?
They have done it as we speak. It's already done.
Did they take our son? Nope. I can see it shining right there in the sky, so how are you gonna prove it this time?
Sunlight takes around 8 minutes to reach to the Earth. It has already happened just a few seconds ago. Because the sun is so far that we don't see it yet.
Go ahead. Save us then. You still have, what, 8 minutes? Maybe you can call NASA. Maybe they can do something.
Nobody on this planet can do anything about it.
Maybe they can nuke your alien beings.
You do not understand, do you? Take a look at this. They are going to build a sphere-type structure that will extract all the energy from our sun. We will have our Earth, but not our sun. It's made from science, so advanced, it looks like sorcery. Even an asteroid cannot scratch its surface.
And how do you know about all this now?
It's just my theory.
And what happens to us then?
Based on my theories, there won't be an us. We have a deadline of a year, maximum.
Well, that's comforting. What happens in a year?
Without the sun, to add the energy, the Earth would radiate away heat exponentially. By the end of the first week without the sun, Earth would be freezing. No laws, no government, panic, fear. Looters and anarchy aside, for the first few days or months, we could get by. By the end of the year, the average global temperature would be minus 73 degrees Celsius. But I have a plan.
What kind of a plan?
That atomic clock was just the tip of the iceberg. All of this data from those beings may have the answer to our survival. But I need resources to figure this out.
And by resources, you mean money?
Yes.
Now I get it. So you just did this interview to get some audience for your absurd idea. You know what? This interview is over. Turn off the camera. I don't want to waste a single minute on this.
Sometimes you have to take a leap of faith first. The trust part, that comes later.
We'll see, Mr. Whatever your name was.
Baas. Ik dacht echt dat dit verhaal potentie had.
Maak je geen zorgen. We bedenken al iets.
Wat gebeurt er?
Hij had gelijk. Het wordt echt donker.
We moeten terug. Rijden?
Please tell me this is a solar eclipse.
No, darling. It's a Dyson sphere.
Both.
Are they hostile?
There is a possibility, but we don't know.
Is this our doomsday?
We don't know.
There's a man going around taking names, and he decides who to free and who to blame.
This is a state of emergency in Europe and the world.
Everybody won't be treated all the same. There'll be a golden ladder reaching down when the man comes around. The hairs on your arm will stand up at the terror in each sip and in each sup. Will you partake of that last offered cup?
Borders are closed and flights have been grounded.
Or disappear into the potter's ground?
According to my sources,
when
many
the man
people already
comes
being selected for emergency shelter.
Hear the trumpets, hear the pipers. 100 million angels singing. Multitudes are marching to the field that is running. Voices calling, voices crying.
This is happening right now.
Some are born and some are dying.
Can we go now? Can we go? Come on.
It's Alpha and Omega's kingdom come. And the whirlwind is in the thorn tree. The virgins are all trimming their wicks.
Four beasts, and I looked, and behold, a pale horse, and his name that sat on him was Death, and Hell followed with him.